Welcome into the recap of the Minnesota Vikings 19-13 victory over the Bears Sunday at Soldier Field. I'm David Kaplan. It's brought to you by your Chicagoland Chevy dealers. Drive what Bears quarterback Justin Fields drives. We'll have a Justin health update in a moment. If you missed the game, Justin was knocked out in the second half with a right hand injury. We'll give you Matt Eberflus's update in a moment. But I want to give you some numbers here. If you had woken up this morning, grabbed your cup of coffee, grabbed yourself a nice donut or a muffin, and I said to you, Bears are going to hold Minnesota 220 total yards. Check. We'll take that. The Bears are going to hold Minnesota to one offensive touchdown. Check. We'll take that. And the Bears are going to hold them to 2 of 13 on third down. Check. We're winning a football game. That's what we all would have said. The man on the freaking moon would have known that. And instead, you turn it over three times. Three Minnesota takeaways cost you a football game, along with Brian Flores being the most valuable guy on the field today. He's the Minnesota defensive coordinator. And it really freaking pisses me off that I got to give the player of the game, the Four Seasons Heating, Air Conditioning, Plumbing, and Electric, player of the game goes to Minnesota D coordinator Brian Flores, who his quote is, "I like to make quarterbacks, especially young ones, uncomfortable." And that's exactly what he did. Five Minnesota sacks, three takeaways, and you lose a football game because I got to give the goddamn player of the game to freaking Brian Flores. That sucks because the numbers your defense put up were really freaking good. The Bear defense today for Eberflus did a hell of a job. Minnesota, as I said, 46 yards rushing, 2 of 13 on third down, 220 total yards, one offensive touchdown. And you gave away a goddamn football game because your offense sucked today. Fields, not good before the injury. 6 of 10 for 58 yards, a pick, sacked four times. But the Bear offense ran for 162 yards, a 4.5 per carry clip. That's good enough to win a football game. But guess what? Flores' defense all over the Bears. And then Tyson Bagent, who came into the game, and he accorded himself okay. He did have a pick at the end that sealed the deal for Minnesota, but he got blasted on one of those sacks. Ball out at the Bear 42. Scoop it up. Hicks right down the sideline. See you later. Thanks for coming. And that is our Feldco play of the day. The scoop and score made it 19-6. And for all intents and purposes, football game over. Football game over. Let me quickly go through a couple things for you. Fields, injured right hand, x-rays negative, but he'll have an MRI tomorrow. He's a tough hombre. If he couldn't come back in, he's got to have an MRI. I'm just guessing. It doesn't sound great. Awful day offensively. O-line play was not good. Nate Davis knocked out when Fields rolled into his leg on a sack. Brian Flores, as I told you, dominated this game. Justin, you got to be able to recognize what's going on with blitzes. It's driving me insane. The first play of the goddamn game. First play. I'm looking. I'm like, boy, it looks like Minnesota. Oh, boy. They've got a numbers advantage. Quarterback doesn't see it. He gets blindsided. First play of the game. Because Flores walks another defender up. No changing of the play. Nothing. And that also goes on the offensive coordinator. It's got to be a better blocking scheme. But your quarterback in his third year can't hold the ball so goddamn long. And on the play he got hurt, that's also what he did. So, again, awful day for the offense. Bad loss. You had all those great numbers that you did against the Vikings, and you lost because of takeaways and miscommunication up front, not knowing how to block their godforsaken blitz packages. Gave away a football game, folks. It would have been a fun victory Monday, but instead, not going to happen. So just to recap, play of the game, the strip sack. That's brought to you by Feldco. Player of the game, I'm giving it to Brian Flores. That's brought to you by Four Seasons. And finally, our Vienna Beef stats of the day. I gave those all to you. Not good. Have a great rest of your day. We'll hope for good news on Justin tomorrow. Tune in at 7 a.m. on ESPN 1000. Hoodie and I'll be all over it. And I promise you, honesty. That's what we always give you. Take that.